Hi there, I'm Martin Grumet. It's Monday, June 10th, 2013, here in beautiful Boise, Idaho. It's fairly sunny. There's a thin layer of cirrus clouds, which is probably good. It's softening the light. Okay, this is a test of my second sample of Nikon AW110. The previous sample, which I returned, was pretty good, mostly, but it had these audio dropouts during the video. So I returned it, I bought yet another sample, and I'm gonna take this into a test in the water. Okay, so here I go into the water. Okay, so here I am. Just been under the water and now I'm out. Water droplets aren't too bad. I see some clinging around the edges. Not enough they're going to interfere. That may have something to do with, I'm going to blow these away though. Okay. That may have something to do with the fact of whether there's, the previous one had some drops. It may have been some dirt on the lens. This is nice and clean out of the box. So cleaning a lens may have an effect on whether you get water droplets clinging. Okay, so here I am, gonna go under the water again. Okay. And I just realized my glasses are somewhere behind the water, so those croakies work pretty well, but they're not perfect. I'll get those later. Okay. I see a few little water droplets sticking. Anyway, so I'm interested in testing the sound. By the way, Nikon and its Nikon's kit includes a neck strap, and the book says they advise against wearing a neck strap when diving. But of course, you want to be able to secure the camera, so I've mainly been doing that by using a wrist strap, which isn't provided. So, anyway, this is my test of the Nikon AW110. So, here we go.